Welcome learners in our studio, and in this program we are going to discuss iapic naming of alkynes. In our previous programs we learned how to write the iapic naming of alkanes and alkenes. So let us see how we start the iapic naming of alkynes. Before starting the iapic naming of alkynes, we must know the word root for different carbon atoms. Let us see some examples how to write the iapic naming of alkynes. For example, let's see this compound. CH3, hydrogen carbon triple bond CH3. For this, first of all, we have to write word root and then last word YNE we have to add. For this, number of carbon atom is, you can see here, 3. For 3, the word root is prop, and as it contains triple bond, it will be an alkyne. So we have to write YNE, the name will be propyne. Also, you can write another compound, suppose CH3, C triple bond CH3. Now, in this compound, we have to give the position of this triple bond. And as the rule, you know, we have to start the numbering from left side or right side. And in the both the cases, you will find that this carbon gets equal number. So we can start numbering from any side, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now just see this carbon atom, which contains 2 and 3 number. As you know, that between these two numbers, we have to choose the least number, that is 2. And as the rule, we have just write the word root for the number of carbon atoms. Here is 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon, then the word root will come bute, and then the position we have to write, 2, and then last word YNE. That is the iapic name for this compound will be bute-2-ine. In the same way, suppose it contains double triple bonds. In this case, as the iapic rule, we have to start the numbering from the left side, because starting numbering from this side, it will give the least number of the carbon. So we have to write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. As it has 6 carbon atom, our word root will be hex. And you can see here, there are 2 alkyne groups, 1 and 2 position, 3 and 4 position. So we have to take 1 and then 3 and di for 2 alkyne groups, and this diene. This is the correct name for this alkyne, that is hex 1,3-diene is the correct iapic name of this type of alkynes. Now see some more examples. In this compound, there are 2 groups. One is methyl, that is known as alkyl group, and another is alkyne group. Between these 2 groups, we have to just find out the priority, which group will give the highest priority. In this case, the alkyne group has higher priority as compared to methyl group. As a IUPAC rule, the group which has higher priority must get least number when we start numbering. So we have to start the numbering from the left hand side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. And for naming this compound, we have to write the first name of this alkyl group and its position like this, 4-methyl. And now the name of this carbon skeleton and its word root. It contains 6 carbon, the word root will be hex, and then the position of these alkyne number, that is 2 or 3, then again we have to use the number 2 and the last word ine. That means the name will be 4-methyl-hex-2-ine is the correct IUPAC naming of this compound. Now let us learn how to give the IUPAC naming of cycloalkanes. In cycloalkanes, we have two parts. One is alicyclic compounds and another is aromatic compounds. So let us see how we start the IUPAC naming of cycloalkanes. As the name indicates, this type of hydrocarbons will be cyclic in nature, and alkanes what indicates that it has carbon-carbon single bond. For example, if we write, this compound will be cyclo and the number of carbon atom is 3, the name will be cyclopropane. It means this compound has 3 carbon and it has cyclic structure, that is why the name given cyclopropane. You can just remember, we can write line diagram for this compound like this. These lines indicates, this corner indicates CH2 group, this corner indicates CH2 group, this corner indicates CH2 group. That is, both the structure are similar. This is line representation and this is formula of cyclopropane, and the name of this compound will be also cyclopropane. In the same way, you can write the IUPAC naming of this compound. As it contains 4 carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, its name will be cyclobutane. In the same way, we can write the IUPAC name of this compound, that will be cyclopentane. Suppose we have given another compound which has double or triple bonds in the cyclic structure. Suppose the compound is written like this. This compound is known as, obviously it has double bond, it will be not cycloalkane, but it will be cycloalkene. And for naming this, we have to write cyclobute and then ene for this alkene group. The compound is cyclobutene. If we write a compound like this, then we have to put the number of these double bonds. At is had 2 double bonds, we have to start numbering in such a way so that it these double bonds should get list number. So we can start numbering from this side 1, 2, 3 and then 4. As it has 4 carbon and its cyclic structure, its name will be written like this. First you add the word cyclo, that is a cyclic structure, and then its number of carbon atoms, that is 4, but, and then its position 1 and 2, the list number 1 will be considered, and then 3 and 4, the 3 will be considered, and then we use di and then ene. The name is cyclobut-1,3-diene is the IUPAC name for this type of cycloalkenes. Another example, you see, suppose the compound is written like this. What is the meaning of this compound? This line indicates, as you know, this represents the methyl group, and you have to start the numbering from the alkene itself, because we have a rule that this alkene group has higher priority as compared to methyl group. So, the higher priority group should get least number, and the numbering will be start from 1, 2, 3, 1, 2 and 3. The name will be, first as the rule of IUPAC, first we have to write the position and name of this methyl group, that is 3-methyl, and then there is 4 carbon, the name will be bute, and the position of these double bonds, that is 1 and then ene. The compound is 3-methyl bute 1 ene. Now, just find out what is the mistake in this naming. You will see one word is missing here, that is we do not have written the cyclic word. So, we have to add cyclic cyclobutane at this place, and the correct name will be 3-methyl cyclobute and then 1 and then ene. This is the correct name for the written compound. Generally students, you just do this one, this naming, this is incorrect because our actual structure is cyclic. So, we have to add this word cyclobute 1 is the correct name of this compound. Now, let us move to another type of compound which are known as cycloalkynes, which contain triple bond. Suppose I have written this, obviously it has triple bond, it will come under cycloalkynes. The name will be just like the rule is same as we followed in case of cycloalkenes. The name of this compound will be, first we have to write the word cyclo and then word root bute for 4 carbon atoms and then the last word yne, that is cyclobutyne. Also you can write the number, or you can write cyclobute 1-ene, that indicates the position of this triple bond. Now see another compound which has triple bond at this place and another bond is at this place. For naming this compound, you just see how we start the numbering of these triple bonds. So, we can start from this side 1, 2, 3, 4. We can also start from 1, 2, 3, 4 and this 5. The better is, as per the recommendation of IUPAC, we have to start the numbering from this side, this carbon and then this carbon, not this side, 2, 3, 4 and 5. The name will be cyclo, then you write the position of these 2 triple bonds, cyclo, this is pent is the word root for this compound, and the position of these 2 triple bonds, the 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, we have considered 1 and 3, that is 1,3-di-yne. Correct name is cyclopent 1,3-di-yne is the correct typic name of this type of compounds. Now, let us move to another type of cyclic compound which is known as aromatic compounds. Now, see how these aromatic compounds are named. Now, let us learn how to give the IUPAC name of aromatic compounds. You should know that word aromatic comes from the aroma word, which means good fragrance. Now, see the most common aromatic compound we generally use is benzene. This is the basic skeleton of aromatic compound. Any compound which will contain this type of ring, they will treat it as aromatic compound, and these compounds should also follow Huckel rule, which I will discuss in the later classes. So, this compound is benzene. Can you name this benzene as IUPAC naming? The very simple, you have just learned how to give the IUPAC name of cycloalkenes. So, we have to start the numbering from this side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. It has 6 carbon. We have to first write the cyclobutadiene because this, it has ring structure, and then the position of the double bonds. Remember, you have to put only one number at the alkene group. So, we have used 1, 3 and then 5. Cyclo 1, 3, 5 and then there is 3 double bonds. We have to use tri and then ene is the correct Arabic name of this benzene molecule. Cyclo 1, 3, 5 triene, or simply we just say benzene. Now, see some common examples of aromatic compounds and its Arabic naming. For this, we can write 1-methyl, we have to start the numbering from this only, 1, or anywhere this methyl group maybe can be at this place or this place, its number will be 1. So, there is no need to write the 1, just we write Arabic name as methyl benzene is the Arabic name for this compound, and its common name you must know, this is known as toluene is the common name. Suppose another compound, aromatic compound is written like this. Now, see there are 2 chloro groups here. We have to start numbering from the position where these groups as well as these alkene groups will get the least number. From this direction, you just always remember when you start numbering of any alkene or alkyne group, we have to move towards the double bond. We cannot move from this direction. So, 1 is here, we have to write 2, 3, 4, 5 and then 6. As these 2 chloro groups are present at the position, first write the position, that is 1 and 4, and then 2 chloro groups are here, dichloro, and then name of this compound, that is benzene. The name is 1,4-dichlorobenzene is the Arabic name of this compound. Let us see one more example of this type of compound. In this case, we have to start the numbering from which direction. Suppose I have written this methyl group is here and this methyl group is here. We have start the numbering not in this direction, from this position we can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then 6, and the name will be very simple. We have to write the first position of these 2 methyl group, that is 1, 3, dimethyl and then benzene. So, it is 1,3-dimethylbenzene is the Arabic name of this compound. One very particular compound we will learn. Suppose we have OH group on the benzene ring. It is generally known as phenol, that is also treated as Arabic name of this compound or general name. So, okay learner, today we have learned important topics, how to give the Arabic name of alkynes, cycloalkanes, cycloalkenes, cycloalkynes and the aromatic compounds. I hope that you will revise this topic with your textbook and remove your misconceptions about the Arabic naming of these compounds. Thank you for watching our program.
प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने।
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने, हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने। जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने।
धन साधन समय की सीमा से
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो।
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से युक्त हो।
मित्रों हम उठे और जागे,
मंजिल आने की ध्वनि सुने। हम अपना जीवन स्वयं बने, हम अपना
जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने। अवसर एक बार ही क्यों मिलता फिर
दुनिया में इसके केंद्र बात। कोई मन चाहा केंद्र चुने, हम अपना जीवन स्वयं बने, हम अपना
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश देने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें। अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं: क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से, जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए।
NIOS देता रहा है युवाओं को अवसर आगे बढ़ने का। NIOS से पढ़ने वाले इन युवाओं ने किया है संस्थान को गौरवान्वित। दिव्यांगों ने बनके दिखाया है सबल और आत्मनिर्भर NIOS के साथ। आप भी जुड़िए NIOS के संग।